from the capital city of Charleston, West Virginia, this is Inside West Virginia Politics with Mark Curtis.
We sure do have an issue with the Supreme Court that we've got to address, and our lawmakers wanted to do that, and so I'm naturally in favor of that, but it casts a little bit of a dark day on West Virginia, and I hate that.
Well, good morning, everyone, and welcome to another edition of Inside West Virginia Politics. I'm your host, Mark Curtis. Boy, oh boy, is there a lot going on at the state capitol here in Charleston. Right now, we're joined by Delegate Shawn Fluharty. He's a Democrat from Ohio County. He is the co-vice chair of the Judiciary Committee. Did I get that right?
Close enough.
He's a big deal on the Judiciary Committee. We got to talk first about the impeachment proceedings that are now, or the impeachment investigation now underway in the House of Delegates. Your thoughts on that overall? Are we doing the right thing?
Well, we're absolutely doing the right thing. The shameful part is we're just now doing the right thing. You know, we called on this months ago during regular session. There's plenty of evidence there that, in particular for Justice Lawfrey, that we could move forward with an impeachment proceeding. And as you learned this week, Mark, we had a lot of people who were resisting that, who thought, you know, we could just kick the can down the road some more. We had a Judiciary Committee meeting where things kind of hit the fan a little bit, and we had to move forward. And the governor called us in for a special session and said, okay, let's do it the right way, finally, after some pushing and nudging. And we'll see what happens now, because I believe we can move forward immediately as to Justice Lawfrey, because at the end of the day, the question is, who should decide the next Supreme Court justice? Should it be Governor Justice, or should it be the people of West Virginia? I believe the people of West Virginia should do that.
We're going to get to that question in just a second, but I want to kind of peel back the onion here on the issues facing Justice Lawfrey. Based on the Judicial Investigations Committee, based on the legislative auditor, what kind of information do you think is there that would justify his impeachment?
Well, we have accusations at this point, and that's why the investigation needs to take place. But we also have a criminal indictment that has been handed down, unlike any other opportunity in our state. Whenever we've had impeachment proceedings, this is the first time in our state's history where there's a criminal indictment currently pending. We also have information that he may have lied under oath to the Finance Committee and the House of Delegates, which obviously, from my standpoint, would be an impeachable offense. But overall, this outlandish spending of taxpayer money that has gone unchecked for years, that's something that I think everybody is upset about, not just legislators, but the public at large, because at the end of the day, we have to make sure that taxpayer money is spent wisely. And when you're spending hundreds of thousands of dollars on renovations for your office, that's a bit ridiculous and outside the scope of what a Supreme Court justice should be doing.
And we should point out, in fairness to Justice Lawfrey in particular, the scope of this investigation involves all five justices. It doesn't just narrow in on him, although he's obviously the best known member so far. So others could be brought into this potentially.
Others potentially could be brought in, but I think we have one that stands out, and I think most people would agree with that. And I think we should move forward immediately as to Justice Lawfrey and then pend our investigation for everybody else following that.
You and several other delegates, Isaac Sponogle and some others, made a motion to set a date to end the investigation in the House by July 23rd so that the Senate could render a verdict by August 14th. Why is that August 14th date so important? Explain that to the public.
That is the drop-dead date, and for an important reason. After August 14th, the power lies in the hands of backroom politicians and Governor Justice to decide, hand-picked, who would be the next Supreme Court Justice. Prior to August 14th, the people of West Virginia would decide. And why is that important? Well, I believe everybody thinks that they should have a say in who the next Supreme Court Justice is, especially considering they elected Justice Lawfrey. He was not appointed. He was elected by the people. And now it gives the legislature the power to remove him if he has infractions that are impeachable. And the power should go back to the people to decide who the next Supreme Court Justice is. I believe you're seeing a lot of political games being played by leadership. We know that Tim Armstead, Speaker of the House, has an interest in that Supreme Court position and has said so in public. And now we have a situation where I believe they are intentionally delaying moving forward so that they can handpick the next Supreme Court Justice. And I think we all know who that could be.
All right. Well, we'll see how that plays out in the coming weeks, because the judiciary committees are now looking into the investigation. Let's talk about some other things quickly that you got your fingerprints on. Medical marijuana, it's still not happening. It's supposed to be legal a year from this month. What needs to be done to correct the problem with the banking issue so that money can change hands without anybody being prosecuted?
Well, we know the federal government hasn't helped us in any regard, so we have to come up as a state with a solution. The solution could be a banking system, as they've done in places like North Dakota. It could also be a third-party system. But I believe, as Treasurer Perdue said, We got to come in and get it done. He gave us two avenues, and the governor has sat on his hands and said on his whiteboard that he supports medical cannabis, but at the same time, he's not doing anything to help it. And we have a July of 2019 deadline here to get up and running, but yet we're just sitting here stalling everything. I don't understand it. We have a lot of people who need help. This is about the opioid crisis and declining about 24% on average in the opioid epidemic that we obviously need in West Virginia, and it's about helping people. And why are we stalling that? Why as a state are we refusing to act on something so important that can be fixed as Treasurer Perdue laid out for us?
I literally have 30 seconds left. What needs to be done with sports betting? That's coming soon. That was your bill.
We need to be up and running. The casinos, we did all the legwork already. They need to build some nice sports books so everybody can get out there and make some money, and we can get a lot of people coming into West Virginia who want to participate in sports betting. And for once, Mark, we're one of the first states to be out front on this, and that's something I'm very proud of.
So potentially some revenue for the state of West Virginia. It needs it. All right, Delegate Shawn
Fluharty,
Democrat, Ohio County, thanks for stopping by. Good luck in your travels back to the Northern Panhandle.
Thank you very much.
And we will have more of Inside West Virginia Politics after this break. Stay with us.